Hi everyone, my name is Ashley and I'd like to welcome you to another episode of our Extraordinary Science Month as part of the NC Science Festival. Today we're going to be doing one of my favorite experiments. We're going to be doing the rubber egg experiment. This experiment is really easy to do, it has some really fun results, but it does require a little bit of patience. This experiment's pretty easy to do using just a couple of things that you probably already have around your house. You need some sort of container. Any sort of container will work to hold your egg and your vinegar, but I do recommend using a clear container so that you can actually see what's happening. You do need a raw egg. Because we'll be using vinegar, which is an acid, I recommend some sort of eye protection. And then you will need some white vinegar. So, we'll go ahead and put on our eye protection here. And again, pretty simple. All we're gonna do is we're gonna put our egg into our container. And then we're gonna add enough white vinegar to cover that egg. Ta-da! That's actually the first part of the experiment. So now what we're gonna do is let this sit. But what's really cool is as soon as you pour the vinegar, you get close enough and start observing what's happening, you'll be able to see lots and lots of little bubbles coming up off of your egg and forming around the shell of your egg. So now that it's in the vinegar, we're gonna let it sit for 24 hours undisturbed. After 24 hours, you're gonna change this vinegar. So very carefully, dump out the old vinegar and add some new vinegar, just again, enough to cover your egg. And then, here's where the patience comes in, you need to leave it for 7 days. So just set it somewhere where it won't be disturbed, it won't get knocked over. You will have some of that vinegar smell, so maybe somewhere that if that bothers you, you won't have to smell it so much. But leave it for 7 days to fully kind of complete the process. So after 7 days, you'll be able to finally dump out that vinegar, wash off your egg, and check out what is left. You'll have this, we call a rubber egg, or some people call it a naked egg, because it's still the egg that you originally put in, but it doesn't have the shell. You may also notice that it has actually gotten larger, which is pretty cool. So you have this amazing intact egg. It's just missing its shell. It's like it's naked. You still have all the membranes. You still have the yolk and stuff inside of the egg, but you're missing that shell. So what you have is this squishy and somewhat bouncy egg. I say it's bouncy. It's somewhat bouncy. Don't go crazy with it. Drop it from a big height. Just little small bounces. It feels very rubbery, very squishy, almost like a toy. But again, don't drop it from a great height because they can burst. And then not only do you have raw egg everywhere, you also have raw vinegar egg everywhere. So what's really going on here? What happened with your experiment? So the vinegar that you used is an acid. It's called acetic acid. Now what you buy in the grocery store is not a very strong acetic acid, it's about 5%. This one I have here is 5% diluted with water. So there's some acid, but it's been diluted to about 5% strength. And when we look at our eggs, we know that eggs have sort of that hard outside shell. Hard, but still fragile. The eggshell is made of a compound called calcium carbonate. We'll go back to our egg that we have here that we just put in. And we see that it's covered in all these little bubbles, and bubbles are constantly kind of raising up to the top and popping off. So when we put our egg with the calcium carbonate eggshell into the vinegar, the acetic acid, it starts to react. When the acetic acid and the calcium carbonate come together, they produce calcium acetate plus water and the carbon dioxide, which you're seeing released as all these little bubbles that are rising to the surface. You may also have noticed that when left for 7 days, that your egg has actually gotten larger in size. Remember we said that this vinegar has been diluted, so there's a lot of water in here as well. A lot of that water is actually being transferred into the egg through a semi-permeable membrane and kind of causing that egg to take on more water and expand. Thanks for joining us for another episode of our Extraordinary Science. We hope that you've enjoyed this experiment and that you try it at home sometime.